Good morning, everybody.
It is Wednesday, December, I want to say 14th, and I'm going to do a 7-day fast tomorrow. Yeah, I was sitting down and thinking about it, and number one, it's been over a year since I've done any sort of true extended fast. I've hit 24s, 36s, I think I may have gotten a 48 in there, but my last 5-day fast was over, I think, 2 years ago at this point. I just had a client recently do a 5-day fast, which was amazing for her. Amy's absolutely crushing it. If you are not in her fat loss program, tune in, you're missing out. Sophie knows. But yeah, I was really thinking about it, and it's time. I've had a lot of resistance, especially because the last one I did was very difficult. But I also had to sit down and realize the last one I did, I didn't know much about fasting. I didn't know the strategies to make it easier. I didn't know what I could do to reduce fatigue, reduce the headaches, all of the stuff that we want to avoid because we obviously want to feel good. And so tomorrow we start 7 days. I'm gonna lay out my exact strategy. I'm gonna document the process. So if you are considering doing extended fasting, absolutely watch this because I'm gonna be going into specific drinks you can make to reduce hunger, what you can consume during fasting, what you definitely shouldn't consume during fasting. Hint, it's food, but we're gonna be getting into it. So today is gonna be more of a keto focused day because tomorrow is the first day. I'm gonna have breakfast probably tomorrow to kick it off. But in terms of allowing my body to adapt to burning body fat rather than go through that process when I'm not eating, I wanna go through it when I am eating. So I'm gonna be eating fully keto today. So with that being said, let's get into it. All right, let's cover some ground rules. Number one, I am a trained professional. If you don't have any experience with fasting, please don't try to replicate what I'm doing. And also always consult with your physician before taking on any new diet or exercise protocol. And number two, fasting can turn into an eating disorder. Seriously, you're never not allowed to eat. When we fast, we choose not to eat because it's healthy for our body. Doing it as a punishment or just because you want to lose weight is silly and it's going to lead you down a dark path. Number three, if you are a pregnant woman, if you are a high intensity athlete, or if you are under the age of 18, please do not fast. You will absolutely end up doing more harm than good. Number four, what was number four again? Oh, why fasting? You mean besides the fat loss, cellular health, longevity, better sleep, optimized circadian rhythm, hormone regulation, improved digestion and gut health, better self-control around food, and an attitude of gratitude for food? I'm sure I could think of some more reasons. With that being said, let's get into it. Okay, so we are going to get things started about, I don't know, 20 or so minutes since the start of the fast. To start this off, so these are things I can have while fasting. They're not gonna mess with autophagy. They're actually gonna provide some health benefits as well as reduce my appetite. Obviously, I'm not dealing with any appetite issues now, but this is gonna be a helpful tool. So first and foremost, we're gonna do half of a squeezed lemon in here. Then we are going to add some apple cider vinegar. And then finally, we are ending with a little bit of sea salt. Electrolytes while you're fasting is important. Electrolytes whenever, even if you're not fasting, are important. So just to share some thoughts about this upcoming fast. So, you know, I've done a 3-day dry fast before. I've done a 3-day wet fast. I've done a 5-day wet fast. And so now we're doing a 7-day wet fast. This time is different. The last video I made, and I'll put the link in the description for that, of my 5-day fast was a very different version of me. I remember the 5-day being very, very difficult, but I didn't really know what I was doing. Now I learned this stuff. Now I consider myself more of an expert. Another interesting thing is in that video, I said, I don't think that extended fasts are good for fat loss. I've completely reversed that opinion. If you are strategic with the way you start a fast, the way you break a fast, fasting can be an incredible, incredible, in my opinion now, the best strategy to lose weight and to actually keep it off. Guys like Angus Barbieri, he did over a year of fasting. He lost 200 something pounds. His story is absolutely incredible and he did it through fasting. And so I'm not saying to go out and do that. What I am saying is that fasting for this long does have many fat loss benefits. And then the last thing I'll say is in previous fasts that have been long, it has been more of an ego thing, and not ego like I'm just bragging to everybody, but I do feel good about it, right? And so throughout the past fast, I have been telling people, hey, I'm fasting, I'm fasting, I'm fasting. No one knows I'm doing this one. My plan is to not tell people. You know, if someone outright asks me, I'm not gonna lie, I will tell them, but I'm not gonna go around volunteering this information. So with that being said, we're gonna drink this and then hop in my sauna and we'll get this thing started. All right. It's go time, baby. Let's get it.
So first and foremost, I had to get a weigh-in done. Now, just to note, this was immediately after I ate, so it is a little higher than normal, but I weighed in at 171.7 pounds with a 17.5% body fat.
Life is so funny sometimes, man. Two things for you. So it's
5:20 p.m. Still feeling fantastic. Number one, I had a buddy reach out last night. Crazy timing of just saying he was thinking about doing a dry fast for 24 hours, which is a fast with no water, which I'm not gonna go too much into the benefits in this video, and I wouldn't recommend it for anyone unless you've done like a 72-hour fast before. But he said he was gonna do it, and so I wanted to encourage him. And so without telling him that I'm doing this, I said, hey, I'll join you tomorrow. So what I'm doing is the first 24 hours after I had that drink, and I had a little bit more water after that, we're doing no water. So I'm about probably 6 or 7 hours in, and I'm feeling pretty good. I'm definitely thirsty. I could use some water, but I'm not by any means in a bad place. But what's always interesting, and I always tell this to people, when they start a new challenge and there's the commitment of like, I'm doing this, and they're giving up something or they're creating rigid rules for themselves, there's always a test right away. And the way I like to look at it is God is just sprinkling like these little breadcrumbs and just saying, do you really want to do this, or are you just saying you want to do this? And so in test fashion, my neighbor just moved in maybe a week or two ago, so we just had the chance to meet, and well, she leaves a bag of beautiful, beautiful cinnamon rolls or like protein muffins on my porch. So they're going in the freezer, but I just thought that was funny. It's always perfect timing, man. And I gotta work on this lighting. I gotta start filming like right here. But like I said, feeling good. Then we're gonna keep it moving. Let's go. Okay, we are 25 hours into the fast, AKA 24 hours into the dry fast. So I did it. I'm gonna break it with some water. I'm feeling great. I really, really am. I know that sounds weird. I know people are gonna be like, oh, he's lying, he's faking. No, I really feel good. Could I go out and run a marathon now? No. Could I go out and lift weights? Yes, 100%. Am I craving water? Do I want water? Yes. Am I okay without it? 100%. But I'm absolutely gonna get some in my system. This water in my gallon has some electrolytes already in there, which again, highly, highly recommend. Even in just your daily drinking water that you include electrolytes, I just put a serving of this in my entire gallon every day. But if you're fasting especially, you definitely, definitely want electrolytes in your system. And voila, first drink in 24 hours. It's a beautiful thing, man. Feeling blessed, feeling good. Let's go. Great day to be alive. We'll keep it moving. Ah!
Okay. Still got that shower hair.
Just got back from the gym. Number one, workout intensity was fine. We're creeping up on probably 38-ish hours. Of course, Yara's gonna hop up and join us. But yeah, honestly, it was like my normal intensity, except probably a little more because I was working out with a buddy. So that was great. I'm feeling fantastic. The only thing, I highly, highly value my weekend dinners. So Friday nights, Saturday nights, I typically make like a very extravagant good with like a high quality lentil pasta and some meat. And it's usually like a really delicious recipe, and it's a big, big meal. And I'm definitely gonna miss that tonight. As far as like physically, no, I'm good. Like I feel it once again, but I'm not hungry, I'm not starving. Like I'm just gonna miss like the comfort of the Friday night of sitting on my couch watching something and eating. So I don't know what this cat is doing.
Are you okay?
Yes, you're okay. But yeah, it's gonna be a chill night, gonna be a chill, relaxing night, and then we continue. We got like over 5 days left, so slow and steady. Good morning, everybody. It's a little bit past 8:30 in the morning, and we just brewed some coffee. So this is cup one. Coffee is an incredible, incredible tool to use while fasting. This can suppress your appetite, and in the process, also give you some beneficial fat burning effects. It does technically have a couple calories, like 2 or 3 or something, very, very minimal, but it does not break your fast. If you do drink coffee, obviously drink it black, but it is something you can use, it's a tool. As far as how I'm feeling this morning, so we just crossed the 46 hour mark. So we're almost to 2 days. In 2 more hours, it'll be 2 full days. And I'm feeling really good. My energy is a little bit lower, so I feel like I'm moving a little bit more slowly, but I'm not hungry at all, like zero hunger, which is pretty crazy to me because normally hunger hits by now for me and then my body adapts. So typically around day 2 to 3 is where you really adapt to the benefits of fasting. So day one, 36 hour, 48 hour is fantastic for health, for fat loss specifically. When you get into like the 3+ days, that's where the real, real health benefits come from. So I'm very excited. I'm feeling good, like I said. So that's my update for you.
A little over 51 hours in, almost 52 hours. Just had a 1-hour, 10-minute intense workout. It was with two of my buddies, and I feel amazing, dude. I feel so good. That was one of the best workouts I've had in a while. My ability to push through the burn was higher. I didn't hit any fatigue, any lightheadedness, any exhaustion, anything. We did some intense sets, we did drop sets, we did super sets, we did all the types of sets, and it's just a testament of how crazy the body can adapt. Like almost 52 hours, I still got 116, all good, I'm in it for the long haul. But I'm feeling amazing, bro. Feeling amazing. So we'll see if we can sustain this energy, and I know the supplements are working. That's it.
Well, hello there. We are about 55 and a half hours into this fast, and we are feeling amazing, and it's a Saturday night, and so what better way to celebrate than a glass of bubbly lemonade? Look at that. Not much better on a Saturday night. I can't forget the lemon. That's the stuff. So today's been great. Definitely cleaner energy. Two workouts today, yoga and some weightlifting. So if I think about it, yes, food sounds good right now, but at the same time, I'm not hungry, truly. At 6 p.m., just gonna take it very easy by the fireplace tonight, read a nice book, feeling good, ready for a good day tomorrow, and that's all she wrote.
Okay, quick recap on the day. So it is 6:10 p.m. on Sunday. We are 47% way through the fast at 79 hours. Quick recap of the day, woke up this morning, felt great, honestly. Went to church and then went directly to a coffee shop to get some work done. After the coffee shop, went and did ice baths and breath work, which I've done breath work a lot this year. And that was by far the most intense session I've ever done. If you haven't done it before, this may sound a little abstract and doesn't make much sense, but the depth I was able to take myself to during the breath work was pretty insane. And then the ice bath was just, you know, it's 50 degrees here in Arizona, and so it was tough. It was chilly, but it felt really good doing it. And then after, I went to a baby shower. Now there's food everywhere at this baby shower, and my intent coming into this was, well, I want this to be my thing. I want to not tell people that I'm doing this. But of course, if everyone's eating around you and you're not eating, people start to ask questions, especially if they know I'm the fasting guy. So I wanted to keep it to myself, but I also understand, like, I can just drop my ego and just share with people, like, this is what I'm doing. And I love talking about it. I love getting people interested, because I think a lot of people think you're currently on day 3.5. You should be grumpy, tired. There's no way you should be even functioning around food. And I can just show them, no, like, I'm doing really well. Of course, the food looked good. So I did get them to pack me some. I'm gonna box this up right now. I'm gonna put it in my freezer because I wanna be able to enjoy it, obviously. Still got 3.5 days left. Don't want it to go bad. So first, we got some dark chocolate, some cookies, some peanut butter balls, some more cookies. That's number one. And then what's number two? I'm scared, bro. Okay. My goodness, pasta and meatballs, that looks amazing. And my friends who made this are incredible cooks. Bryce was actually a cook. So this is not just like any meal. This is top notch, high quality deliciousness that I'm so looking forward to. So we're gonna have this as a celebration after I go through my post-fast meal. It's definitely not gonna be the first thing I eat coming off of a 7-day fast. Okay, off to the freezer this goes. I almost just licked my hand, my goodness. Now, as far as my hunger goes, I would be lying if I said I didn't experience any hunger today. I did. It was extremely bearable. I'm not by any means like dying. I think it was just being surrounded by food that spiked that appetite. So I'm gonna let you guys in on a little secret to basically stop hunger in its tracks. This is one of the many tips and tricks that I show you in my fasting expert's guide. But first and foremost, water. We're gonna use some sparkling water because I earned it. Next, we are going to add some apple cider vinegar, a lime. Now, recently I've been doing lemon, but lime. And then I've only seen one other person speak upon this. It's actually the guy I learned this from. Cream of tartar. Just putting a few dashes in this drink is the magic touch to getting rid of hunger. We got that good to go. We're gonna blend it up, and then I'm gonna enjoy. Cheers. Man. So like I said, Sunday, 6 p.m., I'm gonna go get some client workouts done for the week, plan my week out, make the cats food, and then I'm gonna go to bed and we'll start the week. I got a busy week of calls. I'm looking forward to how I feel the next few days just because I'm 3.5 days in and I feel so good. I don't see this getting crazy difficult, but I also don't know because once we get closer to the end, who knows how my body's gonna respond. I've never made it past 5 days before. So, all right, that's the update I got for you. Peace.
All right.
This is a reminder.
Really?
Electricity.
Well,
crossed the 100 hour mark.
Feeling good. This morning was definitely a little bit different than the other mornings. So slept pretty great last night until about 4 a.m. When I got up, my energy was a little bit lower and I would say I was probably at like a 5 out of 10 of hunger. So it was probably the most hunger I've experienced this whole time. But since then I've had a couple client calls. I have done some journaling. I went to the gym and had an awesome, awesome leg workout, which honestly, like, I performed very well. I was doing some supersets and I could tell my breath was leaving me a little bit more quickly, but my strength was there, the intensity was there, and it was a really, really good workout. And so
now I'm just drinking what's left of my coffee from this morning. I've had a bunch of water today and I still feel really good. Once again, could I go for food? Absolutely, but the cravings aren't overwhelming. I feel very good physically. And honestly, it feels like I have so much more time in my day. Cooking food, sitting down and eating food takes up so much time, which is great. Right? It's important. I love creating that space. It's a nice ritual to me that I did feel like I missed out on this weekend. But when I'm going throughout the week and I have all these different tasks to accomplish, all these different things I want to do, it's really nice to not have to sit down and think about food, but more importantly, to actually take the time to cook it and eat it. Like, I'm just in the zone, I'm in the flow, I'm getting a lot of stuff done. So I'm really excited. We got a couple days left and I'm just in it to win it.
Okay, real talk. It's 11:15 at night. And I'm about 108 hours, almost 109 hours into this fast. I was planning on going to bed at like 9:30, and my energy and my mental clarity have been insane. So for the past 2 hours, I've just been busting out content, work, things that are moving the needle in my business and my life. And right about now, I'm starting to feel tired, so I'm gonna shut off, do my routine, and go to bed. But I just thought that was really cool, man. We're almost to finishing day 5 here, and I'm feeling real good, which is pretty wild. So I'm gonna go to bed. We're gonna hopefully have a good night of sleep. I got a big, big day tomorrow. I've got 6 separate client calls, and I don't know what you guys think about my coaching calls. I don't know what you would imagine a coaching call would be, but it's not just, hey, how's your eating? Hey, how's your exercise? Hey, how's your fasting? A lot of times these calls get very deep and they take a lot of mental energy. So I am very excited and I'm anticipating how I handle the day. So we're doing this, man. And the goal is to just be in my usual state, be a high performer, get the most out of these calls. And then at the end of the night, I have literally a day and a half left. So we're getting there and I'm getting excited. But with that being said, I'm gonna go to bed and I'll update you guys on tomorrow. Let's go.
Good morning, everybody. Oh, where are we? The time is 8:07 a.m. I woke up, I set my alarm for 7:30. I got out of bed like 7:15, so a little earlier. Always when I'm getting out of bed, I feel a little and then I get my water in and, you know, I'll typically add some lemon or something else, some salt, and I feel fine. So once again, we are almost at the 120 hour mark. So we're almost crossing that 5 day barrier. I'm about to get in my workout for the day. Wanted to briefly show you guys what I use for a pre-workout supplement while I'm fasting. I did a whole video on this explaining the scientific benefits and why I use them. We got L-citrulline, beta-alanine. These have been a massive help this week. I've worked out every single day. And then creatine is, to me, in my opinion, essential while you're fasting, even if you're not working out. One of the most studied supplements on the market, and it can really help with the lining of the gut while you don't have any food with it to make sure that when you break your fast, you don't have any accidents in the bathroom. So I'm gonna quickly mix this drink together. I'm gonna down this. We're gonna go to the gym, and then I got a full day ahead of me. But truly, I do feel good. This is not, like, I keep saying this, and I'm a little blown away by it. I feel like I'm at day 5. I should be like drooling over food, or I should be extremely fatigued, but my body's handling it very well, and I really believe it's because of a lot of the stuff we talked about. So yeah, I'm gonna make this, go to the gym, let's get it.
All right, 123 hours in, still feeling good. I wanted to share another little hack that I got with you guys is True Cellular Cyto Detox. I did an entire video review on their fasting trio, so they have 3 specific products. I'm only taking this during the fast. It's fantastic for detoxing. From a health perspective, it's really great to cleanse out the cells. So all you gotta do is on an empty stomach, which of course we got an empty stomach right now. We take a little serving. Hi. Hi. Swish it around there for 30 seconds, and then I swallow.
So it's about 133 hours in. I am done with my long day. I gotta tell you, my mental clarity on my calls was something else. I had a couple deep conversations today and I was there. I wasn't worried about my stomach. I wasn't tired. Like, I truly felt good. I have for the past few hours been really thinking about food. And a big reason of that is with every client that I work with, we do something called a kitchen walkthrough, which is where we go through their kitchen. We take a look at all the foods they're currently eating. And rather than say like, you can't eat that, I give them better ingredient upgrades. And so what I do is we go through it and then I give them a customized report. So basically a document with like links to certain food options. And tonight I was working on a client walkthrough with a lot of links, meaning I had to go to like the grocery store website or I use Thrive Market and find the link. And I was just browsing and just like all this amazing food, like muffins, cookies, brownies, goldfish, Cheez-Its, like all the healthy versions of that. And I'm just scrolling, looking at these pictures. So that's obviously causing an increase in my desire for food. So we've got almost
36 hours left, which is so cool because a 36 hour fast for me is a piece of cake. So I'm super pumped, super blessed. And I don't want to speak too soon because a lot can change in 36 hours. But I thought about it and like, this is an accomplishment. Like it's a massive accomplishment when I really think about it. But if I were to just think about my experience, I wouldn't feel this massive sense of accomplishment because it truly, truly has not been that difficult. And I look at something like my four pass loop hike where I climbed the tallest peak in the United States, or like even the first 5 day fast that I did. During those things, there was a lot of difficulty, and the feeling of accomplishment when I finished it was like, wow, I had so much more inside of me than I thought. And this one, bro, like, if I'm being honest, it doesn't feel like that. Like, it truly feels good. And I know a lot of people aren't going to believe me. They're going to think I'm BSing, but I'm truly not. So I'm feeling very blessed, like I said. All right, guys. Okay. My goodness. We are over 144 hours in, which means we have less than 24 hours until we're done. Let's go. I'm feeling a little less than optimal this morning. So what happened yesterday is I had probably 10-ish bowel movements scattered throughout the day. It was alarming because it was so often. So I started looking into it last night, and one of the things that can happen when you fast for extended period, if you consume too many electrolytes, because your body basically can't use them, it wants to flush it out, and so it'll come through. So I haven't used any electrolytes today. You know, you can probably tell from my mood, I'm in an okay mood, but I definitely feel less active, less energetic, even a little less mentally there than the past 6 days. So we're in the final 24. In the past, this is always the hardest part of like that end stretch, because it's the mental focus of I'm almost there. So I'm just trying to keep a good mindset about it and basically tell myself like, hey, no, I have a couple more days so that it doesn't feel like it's right around the corner. But yeah, man, woo, we're getting there. 24 hours, that's it. I got a couple calls today. I'm probably gonna spend my spare time either walking, show myself some love type of day. Good evening. I am 153 hours into my fast. Today's been great, man. Just had a workout, so I just got back from the gym, and it was a solid workout. It was a little shorter than my normal workouts, but the intensity was the same, which is surprising for not eating for almost 7 days. I'm also really excited because I stopped consuming electrolytes today and the bowel movement stopped, so it's been a super clean day. Felt great. Tonight on the cards is gonna be some journaling, and then it's going to be sleep. I'm feeling pretty good. I feel like I'm probably gonna have energy for a few more hours, so it's probably not gonna be a normal bedtime, but I'm not gonna do anything intense tonight. Maybe just sleep, read a little bit. So I'll be back tomorrow, and I'll see you soon. So it is Thursday morning. It is the day I break my fast. I just did my final weigh-in. Well, I did it this morning before I drank any water, and 154.8, which means I've lost a grand total of 16.9 pounds in a week. Now, this is not all body fat. I'll show you the numbers. And also, there's no way that I'm keeping this off. Even if I was in a fat loss phase, even if I did want to lose the weight, when I eat, I'm going to gain 2, 3, 4 pounds back. I really think out of that, if I was extremely strategic with this, out of 16.9, I think I could keep off about 10 pounds. 10 pounds, which 10 pounds in a week isn't bad, baby. And obviously it's important. Everyone's body's not the same. So if you do a 7 day fast, there's a chance that you won't lose that much weight, and that's okay. So I got about 3 hours till I break my fast. I'm gonna hit the gym, one final intense workout. I got Instacart on the way. So my groceries are coming with my bone broth, all the other stuff I'm gonna break it with. And I'm just excited. Well, we did it. As of 10 minutes ago, well past it, we crossed the 168 hour mark. Look at that green. Let that focus, maybe not. Look at that green. But I wanted to share what I'm breaking my fast with. When you're doing intermittent fasting, it doesn't matter as much, but when you're doing a 24 hour fast, 36 hour, and especially when you're doing anything longer than that, how you break your fast is so important. And so what you wanna focus on when you break your fast is two things. Number one, ease of digestibility. My stomach hasn't had food for 7 days now, so if I were to just throw in a steak or something that takes a lot of work to digest, I would have bad stomach aches, I would get nauseous, I would not feel good for a couple hours. So we wanna keep that in mind. And then number two is we definitely wanna work on minimizing the insulin spike. Your body's very, very fragile in this state. And so when you eat, you wanna make sure it's not directly to fruit, you're not having a bunch of carbs,
So you just want to ease into it. So the simplest thing that you can do is stick with protein and fat, preferably just protein, ease into more easily digestible foods, and then you can have a normal meal. And so what I've got planned is I'm going to drink some bone broth. I'm going to have some collagen. So I'm going to brew some coffee and just mix it in there. I'm going to wait about 30 minutes. And then normally I don't do sauerkraut, but I'm going to do it today because of the bowel movements I was having. I want to make sure I'm feeding my gut with some very healthy fermented foods, aka good bacteria. And then at the same time, I'll probably have some papaya and some kiwis. And then I'll wait another 30 to 60 minutes probably, and I'm just gonna have a full meal. So I'm so excited. This is gonna be a very personal journey for me, so I'm not gonna be recording this, but I will show you the meal I eat, and I'll obviously let you know how I feel after. So I'm just feeling so grateful, so blessed. I was journaling last night and was just reflecting on it all, and I'm just so proud of myself. I'm just excited to share this with you. So with that being said, I'm gonna shut the camera off and I'm gonna go enjoy this stuff.
Well, hello. So it's been about 2 weeks. I lost an overall 16.9 pounds. It took me 3 days to gain it back. Where I started in 171.7, which was again after food, so I was probably more in the 170-ish range. I've been navigating anywhere from like 168 to 170. Now, I gained it pretty quickly back because the weekend immediately after was Christmas, so I had nice dinners, I had some drinks. So again, it wasn't coming from a fat loss perspective, because if my goal was fat loss, I would have operated a little bit differently coming off of it. When we take a look at the before and after, I think it's really important to notice, like, yes, I'm more defined. Yes, you can absolutely see a change in the fat that I hold, especially in my lower back. But something to note that's interesting is the muscles also visually look quite smaller. And while a lot of people go directly into, well, you lost muscle, which we'll cover the data here in a second, it's also important to note that sometimes your muscles will visually shrink when you're fasting because your body's using up glycogen stores. Then when you start to refeed, the muscles will return to their normal fullness, which they did. And so if we look at this chart of body fat percentage, muscle percentage, it's actually really, really cool, because you can see the body fat percentage basically continuously goes down minus 1 day, and the muscle percentage basically goes up, which is the exact opposite of what a lot of people think would happen while fasting. But they've done a lot of research here, and as long as you are lifting weights while you're fasting, human growth hormone shoots up, so your likelihood of preserving and actually building muscle while you're in a fast is a lot more than you think. But now when you look at this, what I also think is interesting is a lot of people think, well, you lost body fat, you gained muscle, and that's awesome. But we got to remember these are percentages, and as I was going throughout the process, my weight was dropping. And so I actually did the calculations. I found the percentage of body fat weight versus muscle weight, and both did go down. We had an overall drop of the weight of body fat of a little bit less than 8 pounds, which is quite a bit of fat. And in the process, we lost about 4 pounds of muscle. Now, again, the exact numbers here are iffy. Number one, because of glycogen stores in the muscle. But number two, we're dealing with a $30 scale. This is not by any means high quality data. It's more something to look at the trends of, okay, how is the weight increasing? How is it decreasing? And following that data. So I wouldn't bank on these exact numbers, but what I would bank on is the specificity of the percentage dropped of body fat, the percentage raised in muscle, but in terms of actual weight, body fat and muscle did go down. Now, if we take a look at where I'm at now, 2 weeks later, so I just weighed this morning and we hit 168 pounds. The body fat percentage came in at 16.5 and the muscle percentage came in at 45.6. So as far as day one goes of the fast, my body fat percentage has dropped and a portion of it has stayed off and my muscle percentage has shot up. So it's really cool to see that in numbers, because again, a lot of people think, well, the weight you lose when you fast is just muscle. You're not losing a lot of body fat. And the data here does say differently. A couple other things to note here was WHOOP recovery score. So day one of my fast, only about 16 to 18 hours in, we had an 81% recovery. The next day, the recovery actually dropped to 25%. The next 2 days were 25%. Then we got a little higher up into 38%, followed by a little higher up 53%, which is interesting because at the end of the fast, you would think recovery is way down. And then the last day on Thursday, recovery was 30%. So again, the sleep quality was really good during this period, but in terms of actual recovery and heart rate variability, that is what dropped. A couple of other notes to pay attention to. So when I started this challenge, I had a breakout on my nose that was actually caused from my carnivore challenge. And over the course of the 7 days, and even what you can see now, is the quality of the skin actually did improve. So my body was able to flush out whatever toxins were creating that breakout. As far as how I felt coming off the fast in the past few weeks, so a couple things I did notice is, number one, the first meal that I ate, I didn't experience any stomach pain or anything like that, but I did have looser stools, I'm assuming because my body was just working through it. But my second meal that day was totally fine. Another thing that I did notice was about a week after the fast, I did experience higher than normal sugar cravings. My assumption here is because my body didn't have any glucose for a week, it kind of went into this overdrive of, okay, if this this to happen again, let's make sure that we have enough glucose to last us longer. It was by no means unbearable. I did treat myself with sweets on Christmas weekend and a few days after, so that also could have driven those sugar cravings up. But if it wasn't a holiday and I really was committed to maintaining as much weight loss as possible, I could have just remedied it with a little bit of honey. It really wasn't bad to the point where I felt out of control. Overall, I'm feeling very, very blessed. We're about a week into January, and I'm aiming to do a challenge every single month of this year and beyond. So make sure if you're not subscribed to the channel, you subscribe. If you're watching this and you're working on losing weight, and maybe this has intrigued you a little bit about how you can use fasting to lose weight, we got a free training in the description of this video. On that page, there's also an opportunity to book a call with myself. But 2023 is about to be an insane, insane year. So make sure you hop in, you tune in for the journey. And of course, as always, make sure to eat smart, move more, sleep deep, and be grateful for this moment. I'll see you in the next video.